And I think that, again, is getting to a common understanding of vocabulary of what is a robot. Because a lot of people, again, if you ask for rules of thumb, and I guess my rule of thumb is beware rules of thumb, because they're all wrong. Right, there's one that's been in the market for 3 years now, which is you need about one person for every 10 bots to manage the bots. That is a meaningless statement, because all 10 bots can be doing a very simple process repeatedly, or you can be 10 bots that are each doing their own thing in a very, you know, very fluid environment. So it's not a useful rule of thumb. To set a sort of vocabulary and nomenclature, and this is what we've done with big companies, that something really tasty went by, and everyone was like paying attention to that. I want one of them. So in the clients where we've done those big tranches and sprints, what's happened is over time we've gotten to know them and us and their environments, so we can come to an alignment on what small, medium, and large mean. Right, and so once we know what small, medium, and large mean, we can start to put a rule of thumb that says, look, a small project takes about 3 weeks, because you've got to document, you've got to configure, and you got to test if this stuff is going to be going into production. And our rule, I guess, if we do have a rule of thumb, it's spend as much time testing as you have done configuring, because these can make mistakes at scale. You can put this into production and do all sorts of harm. So respect it and test it accordingly. And then medium and large is whatever. And so you almost need to put that sort of framework in place with your customers to say, what you've asked us to do is perfect for automation. And based on our sliders, it falls within a medium category, which takes about 2 months.